Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Thank you for joining us for today's ISS update this Wednesday, December 21st. A successful Soyuz launch makes headline news for the International Space Station today. Earlier this morning at 7:16 a.m. Central Time, the Soyuz TMA-03M, carrying its crew of three, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko and European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers lifted off on time and as scheduled from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The three Soyuz crew members, having made it safely to orbit, are now on their way to the International Space Station after a two-day voyage to the orbiting complex. Now only a few hours after liftoff, we're now looking at a live view inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team here has been monitoring the systems aboard the station and supporting the day's activities of the Expedition 30 crew members now on the space station. Leading the team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Mike Lammer, seen there in the right-hand side in the dark suit, and next to him is Chell Lindgren, who is serving as CAPCOM. He is responsible for relaying all the ground messages up to the crew today. Meanwhile, aboard the orbiting complex, awaiting the rest of their crew to arrive, Station Commander Dan Burbank and Flight Engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin are in their fifth week as the Expedition 30 crew, their sixth week in space. Commander Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin had launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 29 crew last month. They docked their vehicle to the poisk module of the space station 2 days after their launch on November 15. Burbank had then assumed command of the station only a week after having arrived. Today, he and his crew members complete their 38th consecutive day in space. With another Soyuz now bound for the International Space Station, crew members aboard the orbiting complex remain busy to support ongoing research into the effects of microgravity on the human body, biology, physics, and materials, as well as perform some regular maintenance and upkeep to their orbital home away from home. The space station with its crew aboard is now flying at an altitude of about 234 statute miles. The orbiting facility is making a night pass on a southeastern track, having made a pass across Kazakhstan this morning's Soyuz launch site about 35 minutes ago, and now coming across the North Pacific Ocean. The expedition crew began their morning with the first of two daily planning conferences a couple hours after wake up at midnight Central Time today. Planning conferences are held with the ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. The crew will participate in another daily planning conference just before entering its pre-sleep period, a couple hours after today's ISS update hour. The crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 3:30 p.m. Central Time. During today's ISS update hour, Commander Dan Burbank will have completed a journal entry as part of an ongoing journal study. Burbank is now deactivating a photo TV laptop to convert the current Russian video signal into a video signal for downlink via Ku band in advance of Friday's anticipated Soyuz docking. He will then participate in a standard private medical conference and begin an hour of his two-hour daily physical exercise. Meanwhile, Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin are working together on the Russian bar experiment that tests detection methods and means for depressurization of the International Space Station modules. The pair will begin their second hour of physical exercise after concluding that science experiment operations. And earlier this morning, Commander Dan Burbank had moved some food containers that were brought up on the last Progress supply ship, that Progress 45. He then relocated some items in the Quest airlock to set up for and perform some maintenance, regular maintenance, scrubbing the cooling loops of the two U.S. spacesuits that would be used during a spacewalk. Commander Burbank also changed out samples for the ongoing preliminary advanced colloids experiment known as PACE within the fluids integrated rack that looks at how fluids react in microgravity. Later, Anton Shkaplerov and Commander Burbank set up and tested the KU scheme for analog docking video in preparation of the Soyuz TMA-03M's arrival. The Soyuz carrying the three new crew members is scheduled to dock to the Rosviet module on Friday at 9:22 a.m. Central Time. With only a few hours after today's update hour before their scheduled sleep period, the crew station crew members will have completed their 2 hours of daily exercise. They will perform some evening prep work and hardware setup for tomorrow's activities. They'll also participate in their second and final daily planning conference before winding down their day with mealtime and some personal hygiene. The expedition crew again is scheduled to go to bed at 3:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.